moving on for your fucking chest hair.
Yeah.
I know that you're, I've seen your videos. Actually, you know what? My mom's seen your videos. I talked to her today. Okay. And
your
she's
mom's
like,
seen everything on the internet.
Though. Yeah, my mom's like, oh, you're interviewing Drew. And I'm like, and awesome. I'm like, yeah, Drew. And she's like, not Zach. Not Zach Morris. And I'm like, no, it's not Zach Morris. She's like, yeah, I know, Drew. And I'm like, oh, okay. And she, I'm like, you seen his videos? Yeah, he's like, he's got so many funny videos. And your premise in your videos is to dispel or debunk many, I guess, stereotypes and misconceptions about Colombia.
Sure.
And let's talk about some misconceptions about Colombia, because I know many of our listeners might be in Colombia, but I think many more might be out of Colombia that want to come to Colombia and are thinking like, holy shit, what is this country about? I'm looking at these guys that speak perfect English. One's from Canada, one's from California. I'm Colombian, Californian. One's from fucking...
Wisconsin.
Michigan.
Wisconsin.
Yeah, close enough. Yeah.
Michigan. Yeah. Michigan. So let's talk about some of these
stereotypes.
Do you Cal-tip?
Anyways, go ahead.
So I mean, in terms of the stereotypes, I mean, I think the biggest one is that I think Netflix has put it's attracted tourists to Colombia to learn more about it, but at the same time, it's put this stigma on it that it's a country of narcos, right? So I think one of the biggest stigmas that foreigners have about Colombia is that it's a country of narcos, yeah. And that like everyone here is like just running around like Pablo Escobar, and that they're
like a wild west,
and they're cool with it. They're cool with drugs.
Yeah, I mean, it's like it's actually, I mean, most Colombians are totally against it, right? Most Colombians absolutely hate this show. They won't even watch it.
I won't watch it.
Yeah. I've watched it because I like it's, and I think it's entertaining.
But
in terms of showing the real Medellin, showing like the real Colombia, is nothing like what it
but,
is.
But
to a certain extent.
Well, I agree and I disagree because Colombians do love it.
Mm.
Love because what?
The narco fucking culture.
Culture, okay.
Narco culture. Because every time we got cable TV, I haven't had cable TV in like 10 years.
Mm.
But since I got rich, I got cable TV. And
the new rich.
Yeah.
Tim Ferriss talked about you.
A nouveau riche.
Mm-hmm. Nouveau riche?
Nouveau riche.
Richard.
I'm a nouveau riche. So I got the Colombian fucking package of their all their channels on. And literally, I go through RCN, I go through Caracol, I go through all these Colombian channels, and all I see is fucking narco fucking novellas.
Mm-hmm. It's what sells.
It's what sells. And you guys love it. You cannot tell gringos not to love it either. You can't tell Netflix not to fucking show that when you are showing it on your fucking TV.
Yo,
because you guys are the fucking disease.
You gotta stop it. Those that are disease. But wait, let me tell you, I don't understand what Drew's saying, but here's a true story. We were in Mexico a week ago, and it happened on multiple occasions. We were all having fun. We're bouncing around, you know, like all happy. And we wear these t-shirts because we love this city. We represent this city.
I rep Medellin hard.
I rep it hard. It's just like I have to switch up my wardrobe. Andrew has a monotonous wardrobe.
I do not. I got Medellin on my back. I'm out. If I ever get a tattoo, it will say Medellin.
That's some hardcore shit. Not me. Mine's gonna say I love mom. And and what happened is we walked up and this group of guys said, "Where are you guys from?" No. I'm talking about the guy. We were in Puerto Vallarta, and the guy's like, "Hey, you guys." And no. Actually, he didn't say where you're from. He walked up to Andrew, and he pretended to have a straw in his hand, and he pretended to sniff cocaine off the word Medellin by tracing it with his nose like this. That was one thing. Wow. So that's the reputation that Medellin has. And
yeah, and by the way, that guy was from Sinaloa.
I know, and he was drug-related, of course. I'm going to tell you why he's drug-related.
I know why.
He was, because he said if we need it, and this happened multiple times. The first place in Mexico City, a guy came up to me, his teeth are grinding, like grinding. And he's like, he's from Sinaloa also, and he said to me and Mike, we're standing there, and he's like, "Listen, you guys treated me well in Medellin. You know, my family, my this and that. And if you need anything here, man, I mean anything, you just let me know." And he's like on top of me. I'm like, let me know. I'm like, yo, we don't need anything. We're cool. Then that thing in Cancun. And then the other one, which was you and Felipe, we were in a house music party. And he's like, "You guys are Medellin. And they start going like this. And Felipe lost his mind, and Andrew strangled the guy, and the shit just went off because Andrew just held him by the neck like this and be like, you know, I don't think the guy didn't really have much wind to speak and continue his sentence. But it seems like everywhere we go, no one goes, "Ah, Medellin, The outdoor escalator. Oh, Medellin, innovative. Oh, Medellin, the green, the hub of people change. Like, it's drugs. And I think that what you're saying is, dude, we have to change. It's us, man. It's up to us to change that shit. Absolutely. But anyways, so stereotype, drugs.
So, I mean, I think the main thing is the drugs, right? So with foreigners, there's two different types of people that have a stigma with Colombia. Colombians also have a stigma with their own country.
Yeah.
And I think that is what actually why the reason I actually do my videos in Spanish is because what I found that the audience that the most resonates with my videos is the Colombian audience. I've made videos in English and Spanish. People, the gringos that watch my videos in English, they're like, you know, this is, you know, whatever, it's cool.
Another gringo talking.
Exactly. So, but the actual Colombians, whether they're living in Colombia or they're abroad, they actually appreciate, you know, a foreigner coming to their country that rather than living in the U.S. and actually, you know, falling in love with their country and sharing their culture, right? So it gives them a new perception on their own country. Okay, like maybe, you know, maybe it's not as bad as I think. Like, I think a lot of Colombians actually, when they go to the U.S., whatever, they're living there for 10 years. Like, I get a lot of comments and messages all the time. They're saying like, hey, like, you know, I thank you so much for showing love for my country. Like, you know, I would love to come back. But the thing that's actually holding them back from coming back and living here is just income, right?
Yeah.
They make more money in the U.S. They make more money in Australia. They make more money in Spain, right? They're not living here in Colombia, not because they don't like it or they don't want to be here. It's because they can't make enough money here to support themselves in the life that they want.
I think I was born in Guyana, South America, and I moved around a lot as a child. And I claim Canada as my home because I've lived more years there now. But I find, like, and Andrew, I think, pointed this out. He says, you know, he thought that Colombians and Latino people were basically dickheads because of when he lived in LA, how it's like a crab in a barrel, like you're Colombian, pull you down. And when he comes here, right, you thought that people were very friendly. You thought that, I think that people who left in the bad days still picture the bad days.
Mm-hmm.
And people who left when they're like kids, imagine if you left with your mom and dad who left at a really bad time. They've told you stories about how horrible the place is. Colombia, Medellin in particular, and we got to talk about Medellin, has done a 180, right?
I learned that.
It's done a 180.
Hey, it's to the learning curve.
It's done the 180, and now things are different. But there's still people that are stuck 180 degrees backwards.
Sure.
And they're still talking the same rhetoric. They still have the same rhetoric from, you know, 10, 15 years ago, and the place has changed. So people like you are changing it. Cheers.
All right. So I guess that's one of the stereotypes.
Next.
I think the other
about the narco.
So yeah, I think narco and drugs is the big one. I think the second one is that the women here are plastic, right? So yes, there's plenty of women that are very fake in terms of, you know, plastic surgery, no nose, you know, boobs, butt, the entire thing, right?
By the way, I love you all. If you want, AndrewMacia.com.
But there's plenty of beautiful natural women here, right? Yeah. So I think a lot of guys come here looking for the plastic, you know, Colombian model, Barbie-looking woman. Yeah, yeah. But I actually prefer the natural woman.
Me too.
Like I just prefer naturally beautiful women. And Colombia has tons of them.
I want them to be perky.
Say that again.
When they're 80.
Wait. Let me just put this on record. Andrew said
that when they're 80, I want them to be perky. No, I'm 120 and they're 80.
Andrew, you said when they're 80, you want them to be perky.
Yes.
That's what you said.
Yeah.